Yes. Okay. So now we can do the posture with the spear in motion, you know. First we go this, turn in, connect, turn up, and step. And here again, turn, you know. So the spear in motion always change from one leg to the other, okay? So now with the hands, it's similar. Yeah? When we step here, one hand swing through. Yeah? Which means we should not extend the elbow, because this way we make the weight longer and we cannot connect with the hip anymore. So this is exactly why we keep the elbow in the same angle. Yeah? Ist logisch, oder? Wenn wir die Hand länger schwingen, können wir sie nicht mehr koordinieren mit der Hüfte. Yeah? So, this is why, like in Zhangzhuang posture, yeah, the arms stay round and we connect with the hip. This way we have the control. So the arm can follow the hip movement. Yeah? So here we swing through, the shoulder is relaxed. Yeah? The fingers naturally come forward, okay? When the arm is up, the leg also highest position. So it means the hand and the leg go up same time, okay? Then when we reach halfway, then we use power and push forward and the finger come forward. And then we hear again, the other hand swing through, you know? And then during the time when the hand reach the same high as the shoulder, meaning the leg is up, then we turn and look to the other hand and turn the other hand. Then we come forward, step and push and other hand relax. So, which means that the one hand always up, use power, compress, while the other hand let go. Understand? So I show you one more time, okay? The elbows don't move and see closely, okay? The posture and the step is exactly the same as before, okay? So here, use spear motion, connect with hip, let go. Yeah? You look into the hand and raise legs same time. Now turn and look, yeah? And go back. Yes. The hip don't stop. No? The hip turn constantly. You see the hip, okay? The hip don't stop moving. Understand? So also with the arms is the same. Over the shoulder, we use power. Under the shoulder, we connect with the hip. Understand? So the arms come close and then the arms open. The shoulder part here, the shoulder part here, open. Yeah? Then you look, yeah? Then again compress, then you open. Yeah? Understand? We do slowly, okay? Look over here. Übei, zau. Don't stop the hip movement, okay? Okay, keep doing. I check. Elbow relax. Finger go flat. Finger go flat. So here like swimming. And slightly to the side. Slightly edge. You holding and then compress. Okay? Yes, it's like strings, you know, like tension, release. Mm-hmm. No? Yes, and you hear?
And then
here, open, same time.
Mm-hmm.
See here? Here? See here the shoulder? Open, same time. Understand?
Mm-hmm. When is it turning?
When you're looking, when you see the hand, you look, you start turning. Okay?
And this is also together?
No, this hand, together.
Okay.
Together, okay? And now see, now you look and turn.
So this is together and this is together.
Yes, correctly.
And but this one?
Don't stop the hip. Huh?
And this one is going?
Going naturally, you see? Like this.
The other part, yeah.
Yeah.
So it's going like?
Yes. To the side, yeah? To the side. Yes, very good, okay? Good, turn around and try other side. This is the part where the spiral motion is very important, okay? So we must feel inside how we use the spiral motion. If we stop turning one time, we have different power and we have hard time to control. When we don't turn the hip continuously, we must use different kind of power and then the form become unstable, okay? So make sure you try to feel what's happening inside and keep the tension. When you go wide, you try to compress. When you have problem to stand on one leg, you push the knee up and the shoulder push down. Then you have the tension here. This is also very important. This is how you stay calm, okay? So try it, okay? Yubei, zou! No, arm and leg raise same time, okay? Don't move the elbow. The hand, use power. See, here. One. Now, go. Yeah. Go. Yeah. The elbows always like zang zwang are around, okay? Just one shoulder, use the tension. Come forward, the other one relax. No, relax this, then open naturally. Now it's open, okay? And the knee turn here, and then use shoulder, go. Let go. Here, stop. Mm-hmm. Here, let go. Mm-hmm. You see? Soft. Then you can raise with the knee together.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. A lot of people have this problem with the elbow, you know? You simply let go of the shoulder. Yeah? So the hand naturally can open, you know? No other kind of coordination with the arm. Just let go of shoulder. Yeah? Then the shoulder open same time. I don't know. Yes. I don't know. If you ask in China, our Tai Chi was first, but who knows?
Yeah.
The Tang Sanfeng is founder of a Tai Chi.
But
then.
Santiago don't think so.
Yes, but.
There's always this conflict.
If you ask in China, you have the story that Taoist from from Transcendental somewhere come to Chen Jiago, and then from Chen Jiago come to Yang. But we don't know. It's too long ago. Okay, so don't think about it. But it is natural that some movements look similar at some point. You know. Because in the end, somewhere was the same source.
I mean, it's definitely based on the Taoist philosophy, right?
Yes. If the Tai Chi is based on the Taoist philosophy, we have the same source.
Yeah. No, I just say because it's like difficult sometimes to change what I did for years.
We just follow the internal principle, and it's always the same. So we try to use the internal power and then control everything from the inside.
Mm-hmm.
So this is how we can stay quiet and stay in control. if no control, we shaking, you know, we stay in control. Okay, I need to check again. Please turn around and I check positions, okay? 预备, 走. Yes, yes. You can actually connect knee and so elbow. Yes, you can connect, you know.
I thought it's just a step, but it's, it can be hard.
Connect, yes, yes. Look here, she connect also, you see. Mm-hmm. She connect knee and elbow. Mm-hmm. Yes. Don't sway, because you stop here. Don't stop rotation. Relax the toes when you step up. Move hip, hip moving. The hand don't go down, always stay same high as shoulder. The front hand always stay in the place. Relax toe, yes. We don't need so much oxygen. Shoulder relax. Yeah. Then yeah. Mm, good. We need a control of yin yang. So one side strong, other side soft. This is how we stay quiet. Look and turn. Yeah. Don't stop hip movement. Okay. Relax. Watch my hip one more time, okay? Just see the hip, okay? Yeah. Raise, same. Huh? Same. Always connect. Huh? Hand and leg connect. Go. See? Yeah. Hip. You see the hip movement? Hip constantly turning, okay? Always turning with the hip. Relax everything. Yeah, okay? So basically it's always here. Turning, turning, okay? It's how you stay strong and you stay in control. Yeah, easy, okay? Just soft, okay? We try again, turn around and we play. So, no heavy step, be careful. So, like a Wudang Tai Chi is very pure Tai Chi. If one mistake, not control, we can see. You can feel and see. We don't need some extraordinary art that looks very nice, you know. Simple movement and control of the simple movement. So there are no mistakes. Then the Tai Chi look very clear. And it's like floating, because you always have the control. The hands stay shoulder high, hands stay. Don't go up after, because only one hand go up, the other stay. Now look and turn. Yes, go. Now exchange. Stay, look and turn. Yes. Always one hand go up, not two hands. Yes. Relax arms, yeah. Okay, one more time. Here, no tension, just soft, you see? Soft, yeah? Swing. This don't move. Soft, yeah? Yeah? This relax, yeah? Easy, see? Soft, yeah? Swing. Just don't move the elbow, yeah? Because when you move elbow, the arm makes it longer, so we cannot coordinate. Okay? Short, I have to explain something, okay? Maybe with your Tai Chi practice, this information can help you, you know? We already know that the smallest part is turning, no? And every movement follows the smallest part, okay? But if you go more outside, like hands or shoulder, every part has certain degree of how long the movement becomes. So in English, it's very difficult to explain, but I have explanation, okay? We have inside small circle, okay? And every part has bigger circle, huh? The shoulder, bigger circle, elbow, bigger circle, and longest circle, the finger. Huh? And this circle always stay the same, like in the Zhangzhuang. The Zhangzhuang, we don't change the circle. In the Tai Chi, we don't change the circle. Why? Because if you change the outer circle, we cannot, the outer circle cannot follow the inner circle. This makes the movement external. This is why the movement is called internal, you know? Because the outer part, the outer circle, follow the circle inside. You can feel when you do the Ba Dan Jin or you do any kind of Tai Chi. This just follow the smaller part. Why? Because the smaller part needs less energy. So the smaller part is safe energy. This is how we don't become tired. This is how we can enjoy. So what happens if the outer part is moving? The circle expands. When circle expand, the movement is external. Understand? I hope this makes it clear. This explanation very difficult for people to understand, you know, when you start the Tai Chi. But here, especially in this exercise, you feel the circle. Because you have big circle, and the big circle must follow, you know? Because if you change the big circle, you cannot finish same time. Understand? So the more Tai Chi you're doing, you feel these circles. And you keep the control of the circles. This is how the coordination can be in harmony. When the coordination can be in harmony, your breathing and the internal movement, everything is correct. The movement finish and start same time. Everything soft and in harmony, okay? So we try one more time and try focus on not changing the circles. This is how you keep in control, okay? Turn around and we try. You play. So. You don't know how to look, okay? I will explain shortly. Everybody okay with the circles? Okay? I also have to explain why we see, you know? What do we see when we look into the movement, into the circle, okay? So basically, in the Tai Chi, you know, now we know the internal movement and everything is very complicated, you know. So this is why talking is not so good. You have to practice more often, okay? But the outer circle we always follow with the eyes. But there are two kinds of outer circle, because the one that connect from the root with the yin and the one that connect from the root with the yang. So it's always relaxation and power, okay? So we look, we follow the yang circle, okay? Why? Because the power always follows intention. This means the power always follows direction. There's always one direction following in the Tai Chi. So our intention is going the same. So the emotional part goes over the it's called in Chinese, qing qi shen, the shen part is what we're feeling, you know? So the shen part connect with the movement over the eyes. So our intention becomes clear, you know? When we follow the Tai Chi, our intention become clear. And we start feeling into this part. This is more advanced Tai Chi. When you know how to move, you connect with the eyes. Because you're not connected visually on the situation. You only have space for intention. You can call it emotion or intention. In Chinese, this is flexible. Yeah? But it means you know what you're doing. You know what you're doing, so your intention follow. Yeah? So we can make empty Tai Chi. Yeah? This is empty Tai Chi. You see, there's no intention. Yeah? Now we follow intention. It's different. Yeah? Follow intention. It's different. Why? Movement almost the same. No? The feeling connect. No? The feeling connect with the movement. So here, we follow the movement. No? You need to practice this more often. But this is basically why, when we start with Tai Chi, you always look at the power. You always look at the yang. No? The Tai Chi principle connect from the posture, from the relaxation, from the strength, and then the feeling. As the Shen is translated to the feeling inside. We feel everything. We feel the fingertip. We know which direction. Because we cannot see everything. We need to feel everything. Then we know what we're doing. We know the direction. When we follow intention, we see the intention, okay? And everything must be controlled, otherwise we cannot follow. So the Shen finish the coordination. If the Shen is not here, the coordination is not complete because something not right. Yeah? If we follow the Shen in the movement, you know it's 100%. Because the movement must be coordinated. If you do it wrong and you try follow, then unstable, you have problem, okay? So this is why we connect the Shen, then we know the intention and we know it is correct. Yeah? There are more other ways how we practice intention in Tai Chi. When we do the movement, you look, but what you do here, yeah? Coming, you feel the intention, the power coming here and go, connect, yeah? Feeling, and you look. Yeah? Otherwise, the movement is empty. Yeah? There's no intention inside, okay? So, I hope it's clear, okay? We try to follow intention. So, now we know all these principles, you try after the half, yeah? You change the look and then go forward, okay? We try to turn around and one more time. Because the strong hand, yeah, from above slowly turn and go over. So follow intention here. Yeah. Okay? We try. Yipai. So. Yes. Yes, it's always changing the transition, the energy transition. from lowest to highest power. And hence highest, highest power, hence fall down, you transition into relaxation. And always connect the feet in spiral motion. So the only way how to connect the Shen with your intention is to find the core. You must find your inner center, otherwise you're falling, you fall over, okay? Find inner center and stay quiet in the center. Look, yeah. Yes, the hands soft. Yeah, hand soft. Yeah, soft hand. Okay, here stay. Oh, see, yeah, soft. Yeah, here open. Yeah, soft hand. Open this. Yeah, use hip. Use hip. Yeah, soft. Yeah, use hip. Hip. You see, yeah, okay. And here stay, yeah, good, soft. Mm. You see?
Yeah.
Very soft, good, yeah. It's like feeling, you know, you're playing Tai Chi. Okay, understand? Also here, soft, same. This, move hip with the arm. The arm just follow hip movement, you know, arm follow hip. Relax this. Soft, okay? We must try separate what is control. You know, we separate control in yin-yang. So relaxation control and power control. This is how we stay in harmony. If everything power, we get tired. You know, it's not good. It's very hard to hold. It should feel comfortable. When you separate relaxation power, you feel quiet, you feel comfortable, easy, okay? Good, so we keep practicing this a bit more, okay? And then we see what we can do.